What is going on, you guys? Welcome back to another video. Today is gonna be a really fun video. We're actually gonna be loading my Jeep up with a trailer, and we're gonna be driving from Houston all the way to Louisiana to pick up a new project for the channel. I couldn't be more excited. I've been waiting very, very long time for this opportunity to get this vehicle, and it's finally happening, and I'm so excited. I'm not gonna quite share with you guys what it is right now. I'm just gonna kind of save it and jump into the clip of whenever we go to pick it up, and then you'll see what it is. So without further ado, guys, let's get on today's video. Appreciate y'all tuning in. Let's get it. Dang, dude, that looks nice. Dude, that's nice, huh?
Hell yeah.
All right, guys, so we just pulled up, and this is it.
When you get up real close, you can see the upstairs and the next area. It's definitely next to you. Not a perfect car.
Yeah, sir.
One of the things that I didn't mention, you know, you can't mention everything. This has been broke ever since I had it. I got it pulled away as good as it was. Yeah, the spring popped off of that post. And, you know, online they show you how to pop this glass out and reattach the spring.
Okay.
That's all 30-year-old plastic. And I just wanted to know the risk.
I hear you.
Yeah, it's, you know, I knocked the dirt off of it, but I didn't shine it up. And of course, the leather could stand a good condition. And it hadn't had anything done to it since August, except run it about once every 5 weeks.
Gotcha. No, it's nice. Looks nice. Hey, inside looks nice for sure. On the dash, windshield's not cracked. 193,000.
One thing that is cracked, the molding around this, the hood hatch, it broke apart during my ownership.
Okay.
There's one piece still attached and there's two pieces laying there. And you can put it back together, I'm sure.
Yeah. I'm excited just to get into another one.
I'm fixing to show you the ugliest part of the car.
Okay. All right.
I mean, a white hood with a dirty mold.
Hey, you got the hood prop. That's one.
All the props are
typically
good.
Those are missing. That's like,
yeah, all the props are good.
Mm-hmm.
And what I majored them is a regular tune-up with the air filter, and oil change, and I replaced the gasket.
Okay.
On these two. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. When I got it from her, it used oil like crazy. And after I replaced the gaskets, I changed the oil, and I hadn't put it in oil since. It's got about 1,000 miles on it since.
Sure.
I did that.
Sure. No, that's funny. It doesn't seem like there's any rust or anything.
The only rust that I ever found was, I'll show you the rust. There's a little bit right here.
Oh, okay.
There was some at the bottom of the wheel well. That's all been converted, and that's black, epoxy down there.
All right.
And then other rust, and none of it was into the metal, it was all perfect. The other rust was back here on the hinges, and this is where they repaired it. and they didn't paint this well. So I went ahead and put a rust converter on it and painted it.
So, dude, this thing's not bad at all.
I know.
It's pretty clean. Like you said, it's like a 10-footer, but you don't see all those imperfections unless somebody, like, points them out.
I know, that's what I'm saying. You bring it to car shows, be like, oh, shit, an MR2, because you hardly ever see these cars.
I've never seen, like, a blue interior like this.
It looks nice.
But I don't mind it at all. But so far, it drives all right.
Smells like an old car.
I like it. I like the old smell. Yeah, it handles like an old car. She'll need some, she needs a little love.
For sure.
She needs a little love, but I think overall, though, I think we can make this thing pretty sweet.
Hell yeah.
I think, dude, with, I don't know, it's nice. I like it.
500 horsepower in this?
Dude. It needs motor mounts. I can feel the engine move back and forth through the shifter.
Oh yeah, I can feel it too.
But that's alright. I mean, I don't care about none of that.
It's an old car!
What I'm after is something that has a straight body and overall just decent platform, just so I can put my K in it. That's it.
Yeah, of course.
Like, it doesn't have to be the cleanest car ever.
I mean, I feel like you could daily this around for a little bit.
Oh, yeah. It's got a little radio in it. Turn it on. I'll let you turn this on. Sticks to get any radio stations, but it's cool, dude. He's got the center console in it. He's got the factory T-top covers, dude. He's got the factory T-top bags in it. Factory floor mats. All that, dude. Those are all. He's got the ashtray in here. Those are all like the first things that typically go missing, like on these things, bro. That's why he was like, "Oh yeah, I got the covers for it." I'm like, "Wait, are they the factory covers?" He's like, "Oh yeah." I'm like, "What?" I'm like, "That's like, that is a bonus." Goes in all its gears fine.
That's good. I mean, he said he only drove it for like maybe 6,000 miles. Oh my god, I love that sound.
Runs good, dude. It's no smoke. It's not smoking or anything. I don't know, boys. I think we're gonna end up taking this thing home.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Dude, it's nice. Like I said, I've never really like been too keen on a blue interior, but
I thought you said it was gonna be an automatic.
No. I like it. I like it. Like he said, he's gonna fix this. I can fix all these little small things he's talking about, dude. Like, that's not a problem. Aligning the trunk and stuff, like. It drives fine though. A little third gear rolling into it. It's slow as hell. I'm to the floor. So look at these pop-ups though.
leaf falls on your car, fucking alarm goes off at night.
Hey, but it's got something on it.
You fucking sneeze too hard, it fucking goes off.
But I like that I can get out and I can press a lock button on it, you know?
Yeah.
Hey guys, so went ahead, just paid the dude. Now we got a MR2 officially for the channel, as you guys can already see. Look how pretty this thing is right here, man. It's gorgeous. This guy is taking care of it, really good care of it. And yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and get this thing loaded up on the trailer, and we're gonna go ahead and haul ass back home. Get this thing home, and I'm excited, guys. I'm really excited. Very excited. Clean title, everything. All right, guys, so it is the next day, and we got the MR2 home. Sorry if there's a little bit of wind noise. The wind's blowing really hard right now. I'll try to block it a little bit with my body, but anyway, so it was a 3.5-hour drive from Houston to Louisiana, which is where we went, and it was a little bit north of Lake Charles, so it was kind of a drive, but like you guys saw in the video, we picked up this MR2, and here she is in her glory. All right, now you guys get to see it in nice daylight. Got the Integra parked right here, man. So I thought I would go ahead and just do a walk around real quick, just kind of show you guys. I didn't really have time to film that yesterday. I was honestly just trying to get up there by the car and then head on out. So let's just do a little walk around. So this car was originally white, and the owner, or the previous owner before the guy I bought it from, repainted it. As you can see there, when they put the spoiler on, it's just a little unlevel, so I gotta fix that. But overall, it is beautiful. It's got the original wheels on it all the way around. It's got brand new Federal, let's see here, Federal 595 tires on it, brand spanking new. And I'll just keep walking around here. So it is a T-top. So this is an NA 1991 Toyota MR2. It is the 2.2 liter. And I mean, everything's original on this car, guys. And it's been really well taken care of. It's got one little fade spot right there on the headlight cover. Other than that, that's pretty much it. There's not a ding nor a dent on the entire car. It's in fantastic condition. So now that I gave you guys a walk around, we'll kind of go on the inside real quick. I already woke up this morning and got this thing titled and tagged, plated. So she's 100% legal, ready to go. So the paint job, honestly, is not the best. There's a few blemishes. For one, the door jams, when they repainted the door jams, they did not match it. It's just a generic other blue, I guess. You can kind of see there on the paint line where they repainted it. So the paint's kind of coming off right there. No big deal. I do have some touch-up paint for this thing that the guy gave me. Interior needs a little bit of work, but like I said, it is all original. This came with a rare option, full leather seats. This is a blue interior, full leather seats. It's got the leather inserts here on the doors. And honestly, for its age, you know, it's a 30-year-old car with 193,000 miles on it. I mean, considering its age, it's in fantastic condition. So it's got the original floor mats, factory floor mats. It's got the T-top covers as well. And it's got a little radio in it, a little Bluetooth radio, which doesn't work too bad. I was using it this morning. The owner even has the factory T-top bags. The original bags that you put the T-top covers in that come with the car. So that is awesome. It's got all these little OEM goodies in it, you know, that typically kind of go missing over the course of 30 years. Seat back a little bit. Kind of give you another shot of the interior. I am going to pull the seats out, shampoo the carpet and everything. My buddy Eric, he's really good at detailing. He offered to do that for me. And let me show you what else this car came with. Pop the trunk here. All right, so in the trunk, We got the front cover, which kind of sits over the spare tire. Came with a nice car cover. So that's pretty cool. Got a nice little car cover to use. And came with TN lowering springs, KYB shocks all the way around with the boots and everything to cover. I mean, the dude hooked it up, man. He gave me a brand new spark plug wire set. Sorry if the wind's bad, guys. Brand new air filter, oil filter, spark plugs, the whole nine, guys. So the AC currently doesn't work, but he did include a new dryer and condenser and stuff for it. So that was really nice of him. New wiper blades. I mean, dude hooked it up. So really excited about that. So, you know, I'm really excited to get into another MR2. It's been one of my quote unquote dream cars for quite a while. The very first car that I ever had as a kid was a 91 Toyota MR2, but it was red. And I absolutely loved it. It's where I learned to drive stick. It was just a blast to drive, and I couldn't be more happier to get into another one. So, as you guys could probably guess, the Integra with its K is sitting there, and I feel like it'd be a fantastic candidate to receive the K out of the Integra. Currently, the Integra, as a little update, does not have its engine. And it's actually out getting a CSS block done. So it's getting a 900 horsepower CSS block. And with the O-ring deck on the top, or with the O-ring on the top. And it's getting a brand new rebuilt head, new valve guides, Ferreira valves, forged CP pistons, Wisco boost line rods, the whole nine, guys. So the bottom end is going to be stout, and it's going to be capable of holding 1,000 horse. Once I get the motor back and everything, I think I'm going to slowly start piecing together some stuff to get this thing K-swapped. And then once it's K-swapped, or once I get everything to K-swap it, I'll go ahead and do it. And then I'll try to take you guys along on the channel. I think this car with my K24 in it, pushing around 750 horse, I think is going to be an absolute animal. But I can't get over just how good it looks, guys. You know, my goal for the car isn't going to be like a full-blown race car, but it is going to be a fun, fast, reliable street car. So that's my main goal with this. So anyways, guys, I know it's been a long time coming for a new video. I know I've been slacking on the content lately, but honestly, I have just been working my butt off trying to get all the parts to build the Integra's motor and whatnot. You know, I'm not sponsored. I'm out here just kind of doing what I can with the money that I'd be making in or bringing in. And I'm not sponsored. I don't have any hookups on parts. I'm just buying everything full list price and just trying to make this happen. So once again, the Integra's right there. She'll be sitting aside for a little bit. And when I get the motor back, hopefully next week, I can start putting together some videos of me assembling the motor. Other than that, guys, that's going to do it for this video. I really appreciate y'all watching. We'll freaking see y'all in the next one. Peace.